Hundreds of dogs rise up against humanity. Lily plays with her dog, Hagen, as her mother looks on. She intends to go to the United States, leaving Lily to live permanently with her father, Daniel. Daniel is shocked to see that Lily brought Hagen with her because his place isn't big enough to accommodate an animal. He dislikes pets as well, but he makes an exception for his daughter. Daniel's landlord informs him that dogs are not permitted. He promises her that he'll handle it in a few days. Lily disobeys her father during dinner and gives Hagen some table food. Due to the small size of the apartment, they are forced to share a room. Daniel locks Hagen in the bathroom for the night. He whines and howls for attention and prevents them from getting any sleep. Lily approaches him and performs a song on her trumpet and Hagen relaxes. Lily falls asleep in the bathtub. The doorbell rings and wakes them up. A canine control officer tells them that they have received a complaint about Hagen and his loud howling. Daniel attempts to lie about having a pet, but the officer sees Hagen inside. Because Hagen is a mixed breed, Daniel is fined and required to pay a high mongrel charge. Lily takes Hagen with her to music class since her father won't allow him to stay at home alone. She hides him under a cabinet. The students play and the sound of the music scares Hagen, and he runs out of the hiding place. Lily's music instructor tells her to put the dog outside and stay in class, but she refuses and walks out. Lily walks down the street with Hagen and Daniel approaches them. He is upset that her music instructor called him. He makes the decision to get rid of the dog and wants Lily to turn him over to a dog shelter, but she refuses. Daniel kicks the dog out of the car. Lily tries to get Hagen back, but Daniel drags her into the car and drives away. Hagen runs after them, but the car speeds away and is too fast for him to keep up with. He waits for Lily to come back. Lily wakes and plans to find Hagen, but her father catches her and orders her to return to bed. Hagen wakes up under a bridge. He searches for food and comes across a dead animal. After consideration, he decides not to eat it. He goes to a butcher shop and stares at the meat. He sees a white stray dog and follows it to the back of the shop. Several stray dogs are eating, and Hagen attempts to join them, but they bark at him. The butcher hears the dogs, and he chases them all away. The butcher notices that Hagen does not run with them and goes after him. The white stray dog appears, and the butcher gets distracted. Hagen and the white dog take off and run. They go to an area where other stray dogs have gathered and drink from puddles. Animal control workers appear and place the dogs in cages. Hagen and the white stray run, and the workers pursue them. A homeless man grabs Hagen and hides him. Animal control leaves, and the man puts a rope around Hagen and keeps him with him. Daniel takes Lily to her music class and insists that she apologize to the instructor for yesterday's events. She complies but sneaks out after class. Lily looks for Hagen and also posts flyers about him. The homeless man sells Hagen, and he is chained up alongside some other dogs. Saabulks comes to buy a dog for dogfighting. He shows interest in Hagen, but the dealer assures him that Hagen is a lap dog instead, but Saabulks buys him regardless. He gives Hagen a sleeping pill and he passes out. Saabulks takes him to his home and gives him a protein powder concoction. He hits him almost daily to increase aggression and keeps him malnourished and kept in a cage. Hagen is only let out when he is being trained and is severely beaten if he doesn't follow instructions. Hagen is ferocious and ready for a dog fight. Lily visits a dog shelter and inquires about Hagen. The woman tells her that he may have been hit by a car or killed. Lily discovers that her bicycle has been stolen. Hagen is led to the dog fight. Everyone tells Saabulks that he should have done better and that he is going to lose. Hagen is matched with a Rottweiler. They struggle and both get wounded, but Hagen gets a firm grip on his challenger and wins. A man approaches Saabulks and offers to buy Hagen, but he refuses, and they get into an argument. The lights go out and Hagen runs and escapes the area. Lily is on her way home and comes across Peter. He is going to a high school party and she asks to join him. He is hesitant at first, but agrees as long as she helps get some drugs into the party. He gives her some pills and she puts them in her pocket. She takes a seat in a corner as everyone dances and parties. She falls asleep on the floor. The party is raided by the cops and Lily is taken to the police station for possession of drugs. She is tested for drug usage and the results come back negative, so she is permitted to go home. Aniel sees Lily and cries as he has been worried. He tells her that he is sorry for taking Hagen away and promises to buy her a new dog. Lily forgives him and they go home. Hayden goes to the puddles and sees the white dog and they play together. Animal control appears and takes them to a shelter. The staff treat Hayden for his injuries and place him in a cage with other stray dogs. They give him food, but Hayden ignores the meal. People come to the shelter and a girl appears to be interested in Hayden. He barks at her and seems aggressive. The owner requests for Hayden to be put down. Lily plays the trumpet and performs with her ensemble. The staff member moves Hayden to a cage. Hayden attacks and bites the staff member on his neck and kills him. The other dogs run from the cages and appear to be following Hayden. The owner stands in front of Hayden and he charges right past her along with the other dogs. They run through the city and attack anyone in their way. The dogs run into the concert hall and the crowd locks themselves in the auditorium. Lily says she is going outside, but Peter warns her not to. She ignores him, so he goes with her. A man tells them not to go downstairs as the city is under lockdown, but they continue on. Lily rides her bike down the deserted streets and searches for Hayden. A group of dogs runs behind her, and she falls. The dogs run past her, leaving her unharmed. The dogs follow Hayden, who locates Sobbles. Hayden and the pack attack him and kill him. Lily arrives and a police officer approaches her and places her in his car, but she escapes and rides away. She goes to the meat shop and discovers the body of the butcher on the floor. She calls Daniel and tells him to stay inside, no matter what. The police try to take out the pack of dogs, but the pack grows larger and more dogs appear. The pack tracks down and kills the dealer. Lily goes home, discovers the landlord has been killed and runs out of the building. She rushes back to the theater, believing that her father's life is also in jeopardy. She gets to the theater and Hayden approaches. He growls, and the pack joins him. Daniel appears with a blowtorch and tries to get the dogs to back down. The dogs do not appear to be fazed by the blowtorch and are very much still aggressive. Lily pulls out her trumpet and plays. Hayden backs down, and with a sense of recognition on his face, he lies on the ground. The pack does the same and listens to Lily perform. Daniel looks on in shock. Lily stops playing and lies on the ground with the dogs, and Daniel joins them.
Alright guys, thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. If you want to see more videos, hit the subscribe button. And if you have something to say, please leave a comment.